We will solve problems for the five most important partial fraction decomposition forms that typically appear within the exams. The timestamps are given below so you can easily navigate to each section. Now let's start with the case when the denominator consists of distinct linear factors. In this case, each fraction will have a constant numerator. It is important to remember that regardless of the partial fraction form, the degree of the numerator always needs to be one less than that of the denominator. And if we keep this rule in mind, then things become a lot easier. Now back to the question. What we can do here is we can multiply both sides by x plus 2 times x minus 1 to get this equation. Then to find b, we can simply set x equals to 1 on both sides of equation 1. So this a term cancels and we get 12 equals to 3b, which gives us b equals to 4. And similarly for a, we can set x equals to minus 2 in equation 1. So the b term cancels and we get a equals to 1. Therefore, the final decomposition can be given as 1 over x plus 2 plus 4 over x minus 1. Now let's move to the case with repeated linear factors. In this form, we have separate terms for each power of the repeated factor, starting with power of 1 and then incrementing all the way up to the given power as shown here. Note that we will still have a constant numerator, b, for x plus 1 whole squared, as we always consider the degree of the expression inside the bracket, and that degree is obviously still 1. So we multiply both sides by x plus 1 whole squared and expand to get 3x plus 5 equals to ax plus a plus b. And then comparing the x terms on both sides of the equation and matching coefficients gives us a equals to 3 and b equals to 2. Therefore, the final decomposition can be given as 3 over x plus 1 plus 2 over x plus 1 whole squared. If you're finding this video useful, then please consider to support the channel by liking and subscribing. Now we consider the case when the denominator has quadratic factors. Recall what we said earlier. The degree of numerator is always one less than that of the denominator. So in this case, the numerator for x squared plus 4 would have the form bx plus c. We multiply both sides by x plus 1 times x squared plus 4 and we expand to get this equation. Now grouping all the terms and matching coefficients, we have a plus b equals to 1, b plus c equals to 5, and 4a plus c equals to 6. Now from the first equation, we get b equals to 1 minus a, which we substitute in to the second equation to get c equals to 4 plus a. And then we substitute the c back into the third equation and solve to get a equals to 2 over 5. And therefore b equals to 3 over 5 and c equals to 22 over 5, which gives us the final decomposition as 2 over 5 whole divided by x plus 1 plus 3x over 5 plus 22 over 5 whole divided by x squared plus 4. Now we consider the denominators with repeated quadratic factors. Similar to the repeated linear factors case we looked at before, we have a separate term for each power of x squared plus 1 all the way to the given power as shown here. We multiply both sides by x squared plus 1 whole squared and expand to get this equation. Then we group the terms and match the coefficients to get a equals to 2, b equals to 0, a plus c equals to 7, and b plus d equals to 0. And therefore, the final decomposition can be given as 2x over x squared plus 1 plus 5x over x squared plus 1 whole squared. Finally, we look at the improper fractions. In this case, the degree of the numerator, i.e. the highest power of x, is the same or greater than that of the denominator as shown here. So we first need to divide the polynomial to make it a proper fraction. Now the division can be carried out as follows. And this then leads to the quotient plus remainder over divisor form given here. And this naturally comes out in the partial fraction form.